In this video, I'm going to talk about logic and three-variable truth tables. If you have not yet watched my truth tables part 1 video, I recommend watching it to gain a better understanding of logic and truth tables involving two variables. When we are working with logic, we often use the variables P, Q, and R for three-variable truth tables. There are 8 total possibilities we need to consider in a three-variable truth table. We typically write true for P on the first 4 lines and false for P on the last 4 lines. For Q, we often alternate 2 truth values followed by 2 false values for the entire table. For R, we alternate true and false for the entire table. In this particular problem, they are wanting us to create a truth table for Q or P and not R. So we will begin inside the parentheses, first obtaining the truth values for not R. For these truth values, we just need to take the opposite of what is already in the R column. So for the first line, when R is true, not R, or the negation of R, is false. When R is false, the negation is true, and so forth. For the next column of the table, we are going to determine the truth values for P and not R. Keep in mind, and is a conjunction. To determine the values of the row P and not R, we need to look at the truth values for the columns P and not R. Recall, both need to be true for this column to be true. So we have a true and a false, therefore this is false. We have a true and a true, so we do get true here. We have a true and a false, so this one's false. And we have a true and a true, so this one's true. False and false will be false. False and true is false. False and false is false. And false and true is false. Next, we will finalize the problem by completing the last column, Q or P and not R. Keep in mind, this is a disjunction, an OR statement. With an OR statement, only one of the two parts of the statement must be true for the entire statement to be true. So we will be comparing the two columns Q and P and not R. Only one of these must be true for this row to be true. The first line is true or false, which is true. The next line is true or true, which is true. Next, we have a false or false, so this is a false. False or true is true. True or false is true. True or false is true again. False or false is false. And false or false is false. So this is the complete answer to this problem. Let's try one more example. I'm going to start with the negation of P, which is simply the opposite of the P column. The first line, P is true, so negation of P is false. The same is true of the second line, and the third line, and the fourth line. And in the last 4 lines, P is false, so the negation of P is true. Next, we will work with Q or R. Remember, with OR statements, just one of the two has to be true for the statement to be true. So we are comparing the columns Q with the column R. True or true is true. True or false is true. False or true is true. False or false is false. True or true is true. True or false is true. False or true is true. And false or false is false. This last column contains an if-then statement. If-then statements are true unless the beginning part of the statement is true and the ending is false. We are comparing the not P column with the Q or R column. So again, whenever we have a beginning of a statement that is false, we will automatically have a true. And whenever we have a true followed by a true in an if-then statement, the complete statement is true. However, the last row will be false because we have if true, then false, which is a false statement. I hope this video helps in understanding three variable truth tables. In my next video, I will be covering a little bit more complicated examples, so please subscribe for more math tips.